What is up? It's Mikey, and today we're going to cover all seven of the new properties, their interiors, exteriors, and nearby amenities. This is part of the latest GTA Online update, the Independence Day Special. This did take a little bit of work to do, so if you appreciate it, please take 3 seconds to leave a thumbs up. So first up, let's start with 1893 Grapeseed Avenue. This is going to run you 118K. It does have a two-car garage. And as you can see, there really isn't too much nearby. I mean, there's a liquor store. But one cool thing is that it's next to an airstrip. So if you order one of your custom vehicles, you can go ahead and pick it up there. Or you can always just steal a helicopter or an airplane. Even though there's nothing nearby, that is countered by the fact there is that airstrip. From the outside, really nothing to write home about, kind of grungy looking. And same goes for the interior. It's pretty messy. The carpet is stained. The walls are kind of messed up, but it's a little bit smoky. And so let's make our way over to the bedroom. It kind of sort of reminds me of Franklin's bedroom from Story Mode. Got some posters and a bunch of little knickknacks here and there. We've got a DJ system. Not too bad. And if you want to change your clothes, you just walk up to the closet. That's right over to the side. The shower, kind of grungy looking, blue and yellow. But hey, it's functional. How often do you spend time in there? So heading over to the living room, instead of the fireplace, looks like they stuck the air conditioner in there. Small TV, but hey, after a long day you want to relax, at least there's a bong right there. Making our way out to the kitchen, there is a radio, and then moving along to the right side, you can have a drink of beer if you like. And yeah, there's a lot of pictures. I don't know who any of these people are. One of them does look like Franklin's aunt though. Moving on to the garage, it's just a two-car garage. Nothing really to talk about here. So moving on, we head over to 140 Zancudo Avenue, two-car garage. This will run you 120K. And looking at the map, you actually got quite a few things here. We've got the ammunition up the way, tattoos, get a haircut. There's a liquor store. You can get some snacks or you can rob it if you want. And it's not too far away from the airstrip. So pretty cool location. It is one of the few where you can jump onto the roof. Why would you want to do that? I don't know, but hey, you can do it. Just thought I'd let you know. And yeah, we see inside the interior is exactly like the previous. It's a low-end interior. Next up, we have 0232 Paleto Boulevard, 121 grand. And this is as far away from Los Santos as you can get. There is no airstrip, but you do have a mod shop nearby. There's an ammunition. And so yeah, if you're looking to pick up your aircraft, you may want to keep this in mind. But it's a cute little house. Simple, blue, got the American flag out front. And inside, yes, it has low-end interior, so really nothing to show new here. Next up, we've got 12 Sustania Road, 143 grand, six-car garage. And if you're familiar with where Lester lives, it's sort of in that area, so not too far from everything, just on the outskirts of Los Santos. From the outside, it kind of looks like a dump. You've got boards covering up one of the doors. Sometimes you might have a transient hanging out front, but the garage is actually pretty nice. Nice and shiny and clean. It'll hold six of your cars. And we have a new interior. This one sort of has like a lot of movie posters. Not sure what this movie's about, but hey, it looks pretty cool. Living room, nice and clean and orderly. Nothing too fancy. Your bedroom's pretty cool. Got some more pictures, and it's kind of messy. I noticed that there's a camisole on the ground. Not sure who that is. And if you want to change your clothes, go ahead and walk up to this closet right here. Bathroom's pretty cramped, sort of has a nautical theme. Got some pretty cool pictures hanging up on the wall. And so we're going to go ahead and make our way to the kitchen. If you want, you can grab beer. And moving along on the opposite side, there is whiskey for you. There is a radio to interact with. And although there is no bong in this property, there is lotion and Kleenex. So yeah, do what you will. Moving on, we head over to 4584 Procopio Drive, 155K, six-car garage. Nice little neighborhood here. House has a fountain out front. And yeah, it's Paleto Bay, so you know what's nearby. No airstrips. And we have that mid-range interior. So nothing really new to see here. Next up, we're literally going to go up the street to 4401 Propicio Drive, 165K, six-car garage. Nice little house from the outside. You know, pretty much the same location. It's literally up the street, you know, so really nothing to talk about. So with that said, let's move on to 4 Hangman Avenue, six-car garage, 175K. And it's not too far away from Eclipse Towers. So if you're familiar with that area, there you go, and the lovely area of Vinewood Hills. From the outside, it looks pretty cool. And once we go in, yeah, it's the same interior as the mid-range apartments or houses. But one thing I will say that's pretty cool is once you go out back, you've got a pretty cool view of Los Santos downtown. Go ahead and jump in your pool. You can do some laps, have a pool party. What's kind of funny is sometimes randomly people will be here, so there will be parties going on. Pretty cool. And there's a nice deck out. You can get a good view of the city. But even better, every time you leave this house, just make your way down the road. And yeah, there's a stunt jump. So you don't need to go all through the windy hills just to make it into the city. Every time you leave, it's going to be fun. You just have that jump. Throws you right in front of the golf course. So those are all the new properties. If you want to see the new weapons and all the other stuff, how to do a fireworks show, I will have links to that down below. If you want to play with me, send me questions, Twitter, Facebook, best way for that. Please take 3 seconds to rate the video, and I'll see you next time. If you want to pull out your cell phone, you know, maybe take a picture or just get a clearer view, you should probably set the timer to maybe 10 seconds. I set mine to 5, and that caused me to have just a split second of darkness there. And there you go. You can have a lot of fun with this. You can have your friends put down some fireworks too, coordinate with them with their timers, and have a lot of fun with it. So the fireworks are interesting that you can put your car over them. They're still gonna work. People will drive through them. So they really don't affect anything once they're set off. Now the fireworks are temporary right now.